As the 2026 general elections edge closer, different leaders in the political arena have gathered to liaise and chat a way forward on ensuring coherent governance in the country. Leaders say that the major reasons behind the formulation of the 1995 Uganda Constitution were, among others, to get rid of an unfair environment that barricades the exercise of democracy.
Now, the system of governance that was all impressive had safety valves that would work to promote democracy. And these were the term limits, the age limits. And these safety valves, I think, according to the framers of the Constitution, were to ensure that citizens can continue engaging their leaders and ensure that they get free and fair elections, but that at a certain point we can have a transition of power from one leader to another without necessarily causing problems. And sometimes you hear our friends in the NRM saying, but we have always had elections. Yes, we have always had elections. Democracy is not about having elections or regular elections. It talks about having free, fair and credible elections.
In an attempt to achieve fairness, some of the leaders suggest that there is a need to ensure separation of power, reinstate age and term limits, among other competing issues at hand.
The role of RDCs in managing elections, the question of the size of parliament, we have serious proposals on that. The question of disguised gerrymandering, I think somebody raised it, a very important point. We also think that, the election results, once they reach the constituency level, they should be announced at that point and not changed at any one point.
The National Resistance Movement Deputy Secretary General Rose Namayanja says that political parties should turn focus on their internal democracies rather than pointing fingers at the ruling party, claiming that it is the chief opponent of democracy.
I want to reiterate that regardless of the political system or form of government that we will choose, and as we continue to say that, you know, political parties were in abeyance and therefore they were unable to proceed, we have moved a journey. Even in the NRM, we are learning to run a political party.
The leaders say it's high time to reinstate political sanity within the country if good governance is to be enjoyed even after the forthcoming 2026 general elections.
So I think we need to appreciate the challenge at hand by all citizens, those in the faith-based organizations, in the interreligious council, those in the academia, the political actors, the business class, different professional groups. We need it all to appreciate that there is need for political sanity as a basis or a foundation for socio-economic transformation.
When we continue to say that the people do not want, who are these people? Because there is nothing that we did, whether it is age limit or term limit, are within our localities.
The Ugandan National NGO Forum is an independent and inclusive national platform for NGOs in Uganda that was launched in 1997 to create space for NGOs to reflect, strategize, and act on matters of mutual interest with currently over 650 members across the country. Derek Asawa, reporting for the news.